That's a 5-inch wheel spinning like heck on top of that coil. Gathering up speed. So you really don't need a 2-inch diametric magnet. You could use a wheel and stud it with about, there's 8 magnets on that wheel. North, south, so forth like that. That's really spinning up. You can use them to actually make a drum the same way and see what happens. And this thing's got all kinds of speed going. I'm afraid that the magnets are going to go spinning out of here. I don't have no tape on the outside of it. So I got to be very careful about what I'm doing here. I don't want to take it in the face. So I just wanted to show you that this thing works like when I'm working with that wheel, and the wheel's really spooling up. Okay, so I think I'm going to stop it right about here, folks. I just wanted to show you that this thing is, I don't know where they, what the limits of this is, but this is what's happening right now. This is the whole setup at that SatGen experiment I've been working with. There's the lights all lit up over there. There's a power box. Here's the coil. And here's that 5-inch wheel, what's studded with 8 magnets. Like I said before, and all. Stop it up. That got all kinds of torque in it. Gee whiz. Okay, so let me stop it here. And then I'm going to show you how I made this. So it's simple to make, really. Okay, now here we go. Okay, I'm going to take this out of here. Just lifts out. Show you the engineering on this thing. Got actually two holes here. Two legs on these things. I got skate bearings on here, and I got them they're welded on with that there's a weld stuff, JP weld, and I welded the things on the skate bearings. I don't know if I can get to show you that. Just lay a 1/4-inch steel rod down alongside of a skate bearing and put a little dab of that JP weld on it, let it set for 24 hours. And you get this kind of result here. I'm trying to hold one hand, do this. I'm doing this by myself, so I'm trying to steady the camera and get these things lined up in the holes here. And, oops, let me get this lined up here. It's not so easy said and done. We're working with one hand. Let me try this again. Anyways, this goes in the holes over here. Slide it down here so we get a better shot at it. No, let's go over here. Try to get this. If you got both hands. Anyway, you can see how this goes. It's like so. I'll just put it on one leg. Give you an idea. And this thing goes in that hole. And the hole is a little bit larger than 1/4-inch, so it gives you the flexibility. Then you could take this. Take the shaft collar off, and the whole cheese comes right out of there real easy, like. Easy to make. No problem. I'm trying to get a real good close-up of how I welded that JP weld on the bearing. It's easy. Just make sure you don't get in the center point of the, when you do that weld job with that JP weld. Oops. Get the magnets tracking that camera. And that's how it's done, folks. Easily done. And you got a wheel then, basically, it's your motor. It's so simple, it's unreal. And why the engineering, such a complex engineering, a lot of stuff, it just beats me when you can have something like this. And it's actually, if it's made big enough, it could power an electric car. I don't understand why any manufacturer haven't gone for it. That's all I got to show you, folks. Thanks for watching.